guys, today we're going to be talking about the blacktail, otherwise known as a dassie, or for your Afrikaans members, a koolstert. Obviously, as the name implies, blacktail is a little bit of a misnomer. Koolstert is a lot better, dot tail, if you want to break it down to that. It's a silverfish, fairly disc-shaped, with a big black dot that sits like a saddle over the part between the dorsal fin and the tail, that little, it's called the peduncle, that section. Sitting on there. So very easy to identify. When they are smaller, they do sometimes have bands on them, but as they get older, the fish will be completely silver with just that black dot. In terms of other characteristics, they do have nice teeth on them, very similar to a bronze bream, and that's for their method of feeding. Forgot to mention, Diplodus capensis, scientific name. Not that you're ever going to use it, but anyway. Yes, for their feeding, those teeth are for ripping off bits of algae and weed off of the rocks themselves, and they're also for eating the little crustaceans and little any sort of amphipods, isopods, and the marine worms that you get in between that either coralline algae or onto the algae itself. So yeah, those teeth are just help them to crush anything, and also to rip and pull off. They occur along our entire coast. There was thought that the species we get, or the fish we get in Namibia, might be a different species. They're having little yellow dots on them. They're quite faint, but there's been no work on it as yet to definitely prove that it is. In terms of your targeting, you are really looking at one of the finest light game fish that we get. You're looking at a 7-foot rod, very similar to, if you go back and watch the video on stone bream. Very, very similar targeting, using light tackle, little coffee grinder, 7-foot rod, 8-pound braid is just, yeah, perfect for just probing in all the little areas that you're going to find them. Now, habitat wise, rocky gullies, rocky ledges, little bays, you do get them along the sand as well, but they do like to associate to the rocks because that's where all their food is. So if you catch them on the sand, it's normally because they're moving between one set of rocks to another. As we mentioned, they feed on mussels, worms, any of the crustaceans, and when they get a little bit bigger, they do like to eat small fish, but it's not an extremely common part of their diet. So we have seen how if you use a little drop shot minnow, you do often catch the bigger blacktail. In terms of their sizing, they matured about 22 centimeters, which is a 3 to 4 year old fish. So fairly slow to mature. They can attain a length of 45 centimeters, which is a 3 kilogram fish, but that's very, very, very rare. Most of your fish are going to be under a kilogram and round about that 20, 25 centimeter range. If you do go down into the transcar, you do often get the bigger fish. A very interesting species, they often change their sex. So they go from male to female or from female to male. They can go in between. And that's just to help, because they spawn the whole year round, they always be changing from male to female, so they can keep spawning and different individuals are allowed to spawn throughout the year. So that boosts their population very nicely. Hence why they're such a popular and common fish along our coast. So targeting wise, as we mentioned, rocky gullies, rocky ledges, that kind of area, light tackle. Natural baits work extremely, extremely well for them. So little mussel worms, if you're allowed to collect them. Mussel itself, little pieces of chocker, pieces of sardine. Very nice for the lighties to catch them, because you can fish with a float if you really wanted to and drift around the areas. Otherwise, a very, very deadly method is to use the little Berkeley gulps. The mussel worm itself, the little camo worm on a little jig head, drift around is a foolproof method to find out if they're blacktail in a gully. Guys, it's one of the best species to get your kids involved in fishing, or your missus for that matter, or your mister. We won't discriminate. It's a nice species. They fight very hard. They take the bait very nicely. They don't feed very shyly. They'll knock at the bait very, very hard like that. So it's a species that's very easy to catch and very nice to fight. As well, they do make very good eating. So a nice crispy blacktail fillet is delicious if you want to get someone involved in that manner, to get them into catching and eating fish. But otherwise, yeah, very fun game fish, lovely fight on the light tackle, and yeah, fun for the whole family. Cheers.